So I actually had a chance to sit down with Mike Herman, the owner of RetroSoft Studios, who's working on a current wrestling game coming out for the Nintendo Switch, confirmed PC, and they would like it for PS4 and Xbox One, but that is not confirmed at this current time. They're making a game called Retromania, which is featuring lots of independent talent that you know, and I had a chance to sit down and talk to him and pick his brain and find out why they're making this game, what's going into this game, what you can expect from this game, and what they want in the future. Plus, they let us know about some cool info coming up for the future. If you guys do enjoy this, smash like. Make sure you check them out on social. All right, guys, so we're here with Mike Herman, the owner of RetroSoft Studios. How's it going, Mike?
Good. How you doing, Tony?
I'm doing pretty good. It seems like it was like kind of a tough time getting together here to try and do this thing, but I'm glad that we finally are. And what better timing than right now after that huge announcement that you guys just made? Do you want to kind of make that announcement?
Yeah, so we just announced over the weekend, a day or two ago, that we were approved to publish on the Nintendo Switch. So our game, Retromania Wrestling, is coming to the Switch.
That's pretty cool, because I don't think there's one other game that was released for the Switch, and it was just recently released. It was like that Japanese game. I can't remember what it was called.
Yeah, Boxy Box.
Boxy Boxy, that's what it was. Yeah. So this will be do they even have the virtual shop like they did on the Wii?
Yeah, so there is, pro wrestling is on there.
Okay.
There was actually, and you know, not to make my competitors popular, but you know, I'm pretty open about it. So Three Count Bout, the original Neo Geo wrestling game,
okay,
is also on there as an arcade. There's a series of games released from Neo Geo on the Switch,
and okay,
Three Count Bout is one of them. Pro Wrestling is the other one, and then the infamous WWE 2K18 game.
The infamous game. Yeah, we could talk about that later. But for people that may not know, that are just hearing about this game for the first time, how did this come about? Like, how did you guys and RetroSoft, how did RetroSoft even start? And then how did you decide, okay, we want to create this wrestling game?
Yeah, so I would say really it started probably 6 or 7 years ago. There is a forum page on the Internet Wrestling Legends forum where I was throwing the idea around that I was going to rewrite the WrestleFest engine just to add some characters that weren't in the original game. And you know, obviously the source code wasn't available, so I started doing it, and I would do it for a couple of weeks, have some progress, put it down, and this kept going on for years. I'm married, I have kids, dedicate the time to do it. I wanted to, it just, you know, unfortunately, you know, work that pays the bills comes first, right?
Yeah, for sure.
So fast forward to probably about 18 months to 2 years ago, I decided I was going to take another shot at it. And this time I decided I was going to get serious. And in order to do it, I was going to have to make it a commercial project, because in order to do it right, I needed help. So there's like 18 people working on this game now, of which I'm probably the least experienced.
Oh, wow.
from a video game creation standpoint. Mm-hmm. My background is in software engineering, but more on accounting and finance software. So I decided I was going to hire people that, you know, had published games before in the past, had worked on published titles before, to help me make this game. So, you know, our big influence, and you'll see, you know, anyone who's seen WrestleFest is going to recognize our game, because we really liked that graphic style, and that's a huge inspiration graphically for us. But other inspirations that aren't as, you know, well known as WrestleFest, for when you're looking at our game just from the surface, are like all the old Technos of Japan games, mm-hmm, that came out, like Tag Team Wrestling, Mat Mania, you know, the other WWF game, Superstars, and mm-hmm, WrestleFest, of course, but also like the N64, or not N64, the Super NES and Genesis games that came out in that era as well. Oh, the early 90s, mid 90s stuff. And you know, I really like 2D wrestling games, you know, and the other one that has some influence is Fire Pro Wrestling, mm-hmm, which is another great wrestling game that I like myself. But all of those have different pieces that we like, and that's why we wanted. But the one thing that I thought was missing out there was more of an arcadey wrestling game, you know, that was like, you know, I grew up with in the late 80s, early 90s, just that pick up and play kind of feel, not super deep, but deep enough. You know what I mean? And I decided we were going to do it. I got the right people on board, and here we are. We just got approved for the Switch. So, you know, if people want to play WrestleFest Engine, they'll go play WrestleFest. Well, and that's what it was. You know what I mean? So we're trying to take, you know, the good piece of the of that, and then kind of add our own take on things, and also add new things that, you know, weren't in that game, or things we want to change, or things that maybe weren't as fun, like me spending $5 and quarters every time I played it. You know what I mean? So, you know, there were certain design elements of that original game that were strictly for arcades and to get money out of your wallet. So we took those out, obviously. You know, simple things like being able to do a diagonal Irish whip into the corner wasn't in the original game. Mm-hmm. You know, that's a big mechanic in our game, is doing corner moves and apron moves and slingshot moves a lot of stuff that just wasn't in that original game. So we're trying to build on, you know, what they start, but we really did like that graphics, the presentation mm-hmm. of it. So we definitely have a similar presentation, again, with our take of it, though.
Right, for sure. It definitely has that feel, and that's kind of completely missing from this day and age in the wrestling video
right.
games. Like, they're super simulation. They're super, even Fire Pro is kind of arcadey, but it's not as arcadey as this is. And right. that's what's missing out of wrestling games these time.
Yeah, I think there's room for another wrestling game. You know, when we just named basically all the wrestling games yeah. that are out right now, you know, there aren't that many. And we're trying to do one that's a little different than maybe a lot different than the stuff that's out there now. I think there's a lot of wrestling fans out there. There's a lot of wrestling video game fans out there. And sometimes you want to play something else, you know, give yourself a break from maybe your favorite game, or maybe this would be great if this becomes your new favorite game, you know. But either way, I know growing up, I bought all the wrestling games, you know what I mean? I played them all.
Yeah.
And I think right now we just don't have that variety as wrestling game fans that we used to have. So, you know, I can think of, you know, countless number of games that came out now, you know, on this current generation of consoles, there aren't that many.
Yeah, for sure. There's the major one that comes out every year, and then maybe one comes by
right.
every so often. But it's right. great to have it, because I always welcome more wrestling games, more just like pick up and play fun, and that's exactly the style you're going for. So you can
yep,
get that mass appeal that maybe those hardcore wrestling games don't get. I wanted to ask you, though, when you started this project, did you know that you had to get talent involved with this, or were you just kind of going to create your own talent?
Yeah, I definitely did a lot of like market analysis going mm-hmm. into this, and it seemed like, I want to make sure that it's clear. I'm not out here to make millions of dollars. This is really a total passion project. Now, I think hopefully as a nice side effect, we'll be successful if we do our job right and we'll make a little money out of it. But the goal of this really is a total passion project to put a cool wrestling game out there. But so I did look at, though, and it looked like wrestling games with licensed wrestlers probably did a little better, mm-hmm. if not a lot better, than ones without it. So that was one of the things. The other thing is just the indie game market kind of dictated this as well. So, you know, it's hard to get noticed. If you look at Steam maybe 5 years ago, how many games were released in a year versus mm-hmm. how many games are released a year now. You need to stand out, and what better way to stand out than get guys who are already established on social media and people know them, you know, even if you're going to get a different range of people. Like, you know, I read comments of every time we post something, everything that's posted about our game, I always, you know, for better or worse, I read the comments, you know, and you're always going to get people that don't like our roster or who love our roster. And I'll tell you, most of it, they love our roster. We're doing something different. It's kind of eclectic and people like it, but you're always going to get the people that don't care for it. But you know, the thing is, if you're a wrestling fan, you know everybody pretty much that we have in the game, and some of the guys haven't been in wrestling games before. A lot of them have, but some of them haven't, or at least not this version of them have been in the game. Like the Blue World Order has never been in a video game featured as the Blue World Order. Mm-hmm. And it was funny, because I was talking to the Blue Meanie, and he's like, yeah, we've never been in a game as the Blue World Order, so it's pretty cool you wanted to do this, you know. So I think just getting the licensed characters gave us some visibility that we wouldn't have had otherwise.
Yeah, for sure. And can you name like all the talent that you currently have under this?
Yeah,
I'm sure
absolutely.
You have more that you're going to announce as time goes on.
Yeah.
But is there any that you currently have right
there? Yeah. So we have, you know, the Road Warriors, which were our first signing, because they were the boss character. of the original WrestleFest, and really should have been the boss character of any game that had a tag team from, you know, 1980 whatever to 1995, you know, the most recognizable tag team of that era by far. So we have the Road Warriors, we have Tommy Dreamer and his House of Hardcore promotion, which is going to be featured in the game in our story mode and in just regular matches in the artwork. Then we have Austin Idol, who was big in Memphis, very big, had a lot of great feuds with Jerry Lawler. He wasn't, you know, prominent on WWE or WWF television, so some people may not have known him, but very cool stuff. I recommend you looking at some of his stuff on YouTube. It was really cool stuff. And then we have the Blue World Order, Big Stevie Cool, Hollywood Nova, and the Blue Guy. And we have Zack Sabre Jr., who is, again, kind of goes against the mold. If I named those first few guys, you'd think, oh, Zack Sabre Jr. doesn't really fit with those guys. But we have some other guys that we haven't announced yet that'll kind of more fit that mold as well. And then we have Cole Cabana, you know, internet sensation, Cole Cabana, great podcast, unfortunately coming to an end, because he's going to do some other things, but, Cole Cabana as well. That, and I'm trying to, I want to make sure I don't say anybody right. that we haven't announced yet.
That's fine. But yeah, like you said, even back in the old days playing those games, you always had like your favorite. So having that variety in the roster will give somebody, there's going to be somebody who's going to have Zack Sabre Jr. as like, oh, that's right. my go-to guy, or even Colt Cabana, that's my go-to guy, or the Road Warriors, you know, iconic. They got to be in the game.
Right.
So it's like having that variety is better than just going with, oh yeah, we're going to go with all indie guys, because then that will get rid of like the mainstream people who
right.
know the legends. And so I like the mix of all that talent. And so like, as far as like other talent that is not actual wrestlers, are you going to have like other like created guys that you make in the game or like unique to that?
Probably not, but I'm never going to rule that out. If we have maybe some cool stuff we can do with DLC down the line, or if, you know, the biggest feature, and I'm sure this was going to come up on the, in this at some point, Bo, is people, you know, one of the things that comes up a lot is create a wrestler. Is there a create a wrestler? And we're not going to have one at launch. Just because we want to really dedicate our resources to making sure our gameplay is solid. So to do a create a wrestler well, you know, unfortunately, we've allocated our budget in other areas for launch. But, you know, if we look to add that post-launch and DLC, as long as we get some success. But we're definitely going to add, we want to add more talent. We definitely are adding more talent than the guys we mentioned for launch. So we'll have 12 to 16 guys at launch. But we definitely are looking to add more post-launch if we get a, you know, get a little success here.
So what game modes are you looking to have when you want to launch this title?
Yeah, so I mean, our want list internally is huge. We want to add everything we can, but you know, we also don't want to get caught in that trap of we add everything and everything sucks.
Yeah, right.
You know what I mean? So we're starting now, and you know, we showed even in the RGT85 kind of announcement video, that's the early beta, maybe alpha version of the game. We just have Hawk and Animal in there. Their move sets aren't final in there. You know, so that was not intended to be a trailer by any means. So, you know, we want to add a lot of modes as much as we can, but you know, I'll commit to at this point, obviously singles tag, six man tag, and we're trying to do eight man tag as well. There won't be a technical limitation, just the size of our sprites and the size of the ring.
Oh, of course.
Eight people might not be fun at once in the ring at once. You know what I mean? So as long as it's fun, we're going to do eight players as well. But, you know, the typical like elimination tag matches, cage matches, we have the cage artwork done. We have Big Blue and we have the chain link fence for those old school NWA fans.
There you go.
Didn't like the big blue. But we're looking to add as many different things, and we're also doing a retro rumble, right? Which is our, you know, our version of a rumble match.
That's awesome.
So, you know, that all the stuff you'd expect of a wrestling game is going to be in there for launch, and then we're going to try to add as much as we can to get to that point. You know, basically though, anything that you've seen ever in a wrestling ring, to most extent, we want to try to add to this game.
And so when you were thinking of this, were you dead set on like getting it right from the ground. Like you were saying, you don't want to put a ton of modes in. So your main focus was, we got to get the gameplay right first before we decide to jam all this stuff into
right.
it.
Yeah. I mean, if we make a million modes and then no one finds the game fun to play, you know, or we're gonna have one game out and we're gonna be out of business. And I want, you know, my goal is to keep messing games after this and make more and more of them. And just fill that different style of wrestling game that maybe no one else is, you know, filling. So we want to make sure, like, if we can't have a solid one-on-one match, we're not going to be able to build on that. So we're really trying to make sure that our one-on-one match is fun. It takes the best elements of all the 2D games we've all played in the past and tries to eliminate some of the ones that just don't make it fun.
Mm-hmm. So when you were coming along here, you did announce just this past weekend that Nintendo Switch, I believe Steam was always the first go for you guys.
Well, PC definitely. PC. So we haven't, I'm assuming it'll most likely be Steam as a distribution, but we haven't set up our page yet there, or anything like that, but it'll probably most likely be Steam, but PC release and definitely Switch. And we are seeking approval on the other two consoles as well. The goal is to release on Switch, PS4, Xbox One, all at the same time. So that's the goal, but we can only confirm right now we have Switch approval and obviously PC.
So then what is the goal? Like, what would be the initial release time that you would like to get this game out?
We're targeting the first quarter of 2020. So okay, less than a year.
I feel like this is coming along pretty fast, though. Am I right here? Because the last time I spoke, I thought I just saw screenshots, and then there's more roster announcements, then there's a Switch announcement. I feel like you're just chugging along here.
Yeah, we are. We have a lot, like I said, we have a lot of people working on it. And the biggest thing is we have so much artwork. So we drew all the sprites from hand, referencing, you know, we've watched a lot of YouTube videos of wrestling moves. You know, we've played a lot of 2D wrestling games to get an idea and tried to take, you know, bits and pieces of everything to make our own moveset in there. But we've a lot of artwork, and then we have four different body types in there that we're modifying. And then we're coloring on top of those body types all of our characters. So the biggest thing is getting all the artwork done in a timely manner. So, you know, I'm optimistic though. We have been chugging along pretty good, and I'm hoping that continues.
Yeah, that's awesome. I'm glad to hear, because we, again, like I said before, we need more of these retro wrestling games that everybody remembers that they were playing.
Yeah, I mean, I just think it's you know, there's some great, and look, I own Fire Pro, I own WWE 2K. I like both those games. I'm not gonna lie, I like the latest greatest 3D engines playing my games. I like the depth of Fire Pro, but I don't have, you know, that arcade 2D feel that I remember growing up with, that I think, you know, and I have young kids, they've been playing with me on our build, they like it, you know, and I think there's a market, and I think, you know, and the Switch has proven that, and I think the other consoles as well have really really taken on the indie development scene and is willing to put these games out there because there's a market for them.
Yeah, definitely that Nintendo Switch will be a great market. They're embracing the indie game market now, and that's huge. And then also with the PC, you can get the indie market as well. And again, there's just that void that's missing there, and I feel like you guys are going to fill that void, and hopefully this is successful, and then you can do more great things going forward.
That's the goal.
Is there any other thing that you want to make sure that you get out of the way before we do wrap it up here?
No, just keep following us. We have social media on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. Just search Retromania. It's at Retrosoft Studio. You'll find us and keep up with us. We have a mailing list if you want to get more information on it. Webpage, www.retrosoftstudios.com. Just keep up with us on social media. We got one of my colleagues at work handles our Twitter and does a really good job of not just posting about our game, but some pretty like cool old school wrestling posts. Old match cards, you know, a lot of cool stuff. So if you're just into wrestling, I think we're a really good Twitter follow, and Instagram for that matter, and Facebook. But, if you're into that kind of stuff, and if you're listening to this, you probably are, check out our social media. We think you'll like it. Yeah, since we announced the Switch, we're giving away, as soon as they ship, we're going to get one to our winner. So if you follow us on any of our social media, you'll be entered to win. If you follow us on everything, you get an extra chances to win. And we're going to do a random pick, and we're going to send out as soon as it launches, we're going to get you a Switch Lite on us.
That's awesome. That's great. I don't have a Switch yet, so I'll definitely be in on that. So looking forward to playing this. Can't wait. Thank you for your time. Sorry it took so long to get this all worked out.
Hey, apology from my end, too. It wasn't just you. It was me, too.
But that's good. I'm glad to see that it's coming along. You got that talent involved. That's awesome. And I'm just eyes are open. Looking forward to seeing more from you guys.
Awesome. Thanks, man.
Thanks a lot.